and Julius, Fabricius, prefect of the Weald, in the days of Diocletian owned our lower river field. He called to him Hopinius, a Briton of the clay, saying, what about that river peaceful lane? Into he and that aged Hobden answered, I remember as a lad that my father told your father that she wanted to rain and bag. And the more that you neglect, the less you'll get her clean. Have just as you've a mind to, but if I was you, I'd rain. So they drained it long and crossways in the lavish Roman style. Still we find among the river drift their flakes of ancient tile. And in drouthy middle August, when the bones of meadows show, we can trace the lines they followed 1500 years ago. And then Julius Fabricius died, as even prefects do. And then after certain centuries, imperial Rome died too. Then did robbers enter Britain from across the northern main, and our lower river field was won by Ogier the Dane. Well could Ogier work his warboat, well could Ogier wield his brand, much he knew of foaming waters, not so much of farming land. So he called to him a Hobden of the old unaltered blood, saying, what about that river piece? She doesn't look no good. And that aged Hobden answered, 'tain't for me to interfere, but I've known that bit of meadow now for 55 years. Ah, but just as you've a mind to, but I proved it time on time. If you want to change her nature, you have got to give her lime. Ogier sent his wains to Lewis 20 hours solemn walk, and drew back great abundance of the cool grey healing chalk. And old Hobden spread it broadcast, never heeding what was in't, which is why in cleaning ditches now and then we find a flint. Ogier died, his sons grew English, Anglo-Saxon was their name, until out of Blossom Normandy, the pirate came. For Duke William conquered England and divided with his men, and our lower river field he gave to William of Warren. But the brook, you know her habit, rose one rainy autumn night, iron tore down sodden glitches of the bank to left and right. So said William to his bailiff, as he rode there dripping round, up, what about that river bit? The brook's got up no bounds. And that aged Hobden answered, 'tain't my business to advise, but you might have known 'twould happen from the way the barley lies. And where you can't hold back the water, you must try and save the sail. Have it just as you've a mind to, but if I was you, I'd spile. So they spiled along the watercourse with trunks of willow trees and planks of elm behind them and immortal oaken knees. And oh, when the spades of autumn, well, the gravel beds they weigh, you can see their faithful fragments, iron hard in iron clay. Georgiae Quintiano Sexto, I who own the river field, am fortified by title deeds, attested, signed and sealed, guaranteeing me my assigns, my executors and heirs, all sorts of powers and profit, which are neither mine nor theirs. I have rights of chase and warren, as my dignity requires. I can fish, but Hobden tickles. I can shoot, but Hobden wires. I repair, but he reopens certain gaps which men allege have been used by every Hobden since a Hobden swapped a hedge. Shall I dog his morning progress or the track betraying you? Demand his dinner basket into which my pheasant flew. Confiscate his evening faggot under which my conies ran, and summons him to judgment. I would sooner summons Pan. For his dead are in the churchyard 30 generations late. Aye, their names were old in history when Doomsday Book was made. and the passion and the piety and prowess of his line of seeded, rooted in some land. The law calls mine, not for any beast that burrows, not for any bird that flies, would I ill miss his large sound counsel, miss his keen amending eyes. He is bailiff, woodman, wheelwright, field surveyor, engineer, and if flagrantly a poacher, tain for me to interfere. Ah, but what about that river bit? I turn to him again, with Fabricius and Ogier, and William of Warren. Have it just as you've a mind to, but, and here he takes command. For whoever pays the taxes, old Miss Hobden owns the land.